Well, no surprise there, a little bell at the food dish. And the girls don't seem any worse for the wear. There's Sally running around with a bully stick, growling at Lucy, no, Patty, who was sucking up to Viclaire. Viclaire and those guys came to get Jedi. It was great meeting them. They're wonderful, of course. And like I say, the girls seem to be taking the loss of the boys in stride, although at first they seemed a little nervous to get out of the pen, like they didn't want to go. But then they got over to their little, this is definitely their favorite area, I think. Even though that porch is awesome, they love coming here because they like my suspension bridge. So I'm very proud about that. Sal, are you my gal pal, Sal? She's got a little chewy. Hello, Belle Belle. Hello, everybody. Look at these little sweet peas. And they're loving. So now we can get a good look at each of them. There's Miss Lucy, looking gorgeous. Hi, Luce. Beautiful. And then we got little Patty in there. And hi, Belle. What you doing, Belle? And what's my little Sally bad girl doing? Actually, she is normally good and, like I say, not aggressive, but she's Sally, what you got? I'm going to take the bully stick away. I think, guys, I just wanted to give you a quick video of just us girls. But the reason I'll get it taken away, look at her going under the stairs, is because I want to make sure she eats. Although it's really good that little Lucy's eating, too. When we weighed him, though, the littlest weight, Lexi weighed him at 8 weeks, which we haven't done with any of the puppies. And we both thought they were smaller than the love litter, but at least the scale doesn't show them any smaller than what would be expected for this age. But Lucy and, not Lucy, I mean Belle. Belle and Jose were the littlest. Lucy was the third. Oh, Patty, good score. Look at that. And now I got to take it away from you girls in a minute so you can eat your food. Oh, here come Belle. Belle likes that idea, getting them distracted with a bully stick so she can eat. So Belle and Jose, the smallest, but look at her. She is cute, Henrietta. I can't lie. Oh, Belle, Belle. Look at her. If I end up keeping Belle, everyone will need to know that it's actually in spite of her color. As unique and gorgeous as it is, you know, as a breeder, you prefer to have the darker reds and the non-dilute colors. But again, what I learned from one lady who gave me a lot of good advice over in England on a blog was that any dogs can carry dilute, even if you breed to the dark, rich reds. And we did. I mean, Willow's a dark, rich red, and the sire we bred to is a dark, rich red. And in the first litter, there were only reds and red and whites, but Belle is the blue. But what's controversial in England, because people are breeding blue to blue just to get blue. But of course, she's just the result of a natural breeding. So I would never anticipate coat problems or anything. It would just be wanting to make sure I continue to get reds. And if you breed, even if like if I find a beautiful black sire and I bred it to any of these dogs, we would only get black or black brindle or brindley type dogs, as I understand it, unless they carry red, and not all black dogs carry red. So I probably will try to always find a good red sire if I can. That said, you never breed for color, so I would find the best sire and hope that I could find a red one that is like a 9.5 compared to a black brindle that might be a 10. And if my bitch is good, ooh, I swore on, usually don't use my dog show lingo, but anyway, if my girl is that good, then I could do the 9.5. So that's my plan. But I say if I keep Belle, because I'm starting to get it kind of narrowed down. So I will give everybody the notion that she's one of the choices. And again, it is despite her color. And I have to have my decision done by next Monday. So I appreciate everyone being patient, but I think it's really good to take time, isn't it, Lucy? Because you just never know. And like I say, I'm very much studying now temperamental traits of everybody and what people have asked for and situations of living, in addition to the fact that the one we keep. And so what's really kind of cool is, again, I think once again, and I feel blessed and grateful, not trying to brag, but blessed and grateful, right, Luce, that they ended up, I think everybody believes they got the dog they were meant to already, as now Franklin is happily at home in Arizona. little Jose Peterson, who I think is going to keep his name, which is awesome. Rookie of the Year is on his way to Portland, and I will be seeing him very soon in the show rings. And then we've got our beautiful little Chuck, my angel sweetheart Jedi, going to a wonderful family just a couple of hours away, and we'll see them at the baby puppy contest. Thanks, guys. At least one of them in Lodi or Sacramento. And I think when they get a peek at how fun it will be and probably how easy Mr. Jedi will get his show championship, that will be something we can do over the next year or two as well. So anyway, feeling very happy, right, girls? Hi, Belle. Say hi to Henrietta. She loves you. Yeah, I know. All right. Hi, everybody. Okay, good job there, Patty. Good job. Patty swiped it. All right, but I got to take these away because they're not eating much. Okay, bye, everybody.